Welcome to the Spy Collection. This is Anastasios, and the item we will look at today is quite old. It's an American spy camera from the early 20th century, known as the Expo watch camera. Around 1905, the Expo watch sub-miniature camera appeared in the market. It was a camera designed by the Swedish engineer Magnus Niéll and manufactured in the United States. Regardless of its name and its apparent objective to be easily concealable, the camera wasn't designed for any intelligence agency or police force at that time. As you can see in this advertisement from October 1917 at the Popular Mechanics magazine, it was likely one of the earliest devices built purposely for covert photography. The advertisement describes it as a camera that closely resembles a watch in size and appearance, takes pictures in 5/8 by 7/8 inches as shown on margin. Easy to operate, it's a camera for both the amateur and professional. Surprise your friends! And this is indeed true. This camera was first produced in New York in the United States in 1905 and continued to be produced until 1939. During that time, it was used for covert photography by both friends surprising each other, as the advertisement describes it, but also by police forces doing surveillance. If you want to read more details on the history, technical specifications and operation of this spy camera, I recommend you to check out this blog post by Kurt Manger. It goes as far as testing out the exact same model and has even calculated that its resolution is similar to a 0.3 megapixel camera. As always, I'll leave the link in the description. It's a very lightweight camera with nickel-plated brass cover and with a main body being made out of nickel-plated steel. Its aperture is not adjustable and it is 27mm, which is equivalent to something around f1.3. This is giving it a rough focal distance of around 3 meters. That's roughly 10 feet. Regarding its shutter speed, that is the door that controls how long the film will be exposed, it has two options. The instant, which is around 1/90 of a second, and the manual setting where the operator controls it. Regarding its film, I don't have one here, but it was an 18mm wide film and each cartridge had slots for 20 photographs. In the photo here you can see how this cartridge looked like. In terms of the operating mechanism, the camera doesn't have a lot of external controls. This is the top side, which is also the camera cover, and it only has the brand of the camera, Expo. On the other side, we have the winder and a small window. Anytime the operator is taking a photo, they use this winder to get to the next slot of the film. You can better see it here. The left side of the camera has nothing but a screw that is used to secure the body, and on the right side we have two extra controls. The long lever that you see on the top has the markings T and I. Those markings stand for time and instant, and it is what is used to control the shutter speed. The shutter is controlled by the other lever that you see over here. So if we put in the instant, it is where the camera will have the shutter speed of 1/90 of a second. So let's see that. And on the adjustable setting, on the time-based setting, it will last as long as the operator holds the shutter button depressed. The last but most important control on the camera is the lens cover. You can better see it here. This is secured using this chain, and inside there we have the lens, which is 27mm. if someone wants to take a photo, let's say on the instant mode, they will point the camera to the direction they want it to, and they will just use the shutter trigger button. Now that I went through how it is being used, let's have a look at its very simple operating mechanism. This rod is what the winder is turning in order to turn the film so that the next slot can move right behind the shutter. And how the camera works is that we adjust the speed, and then you can clearly see the shutter from here and how it works when we trigger it. Let me do that one more time for you. So now we have the instant setting that's going to open it for 1/90 of a second. And here we have the time-based setting, which is controlled by the operator. Oh, that's the time setting controlled by the operator. And once again, the instant setting. Once again, using the blog post by Kurt Manger, we can see that he even took some photographs using this exact same model from the early 20th century. In conclusion, spy cameras are nothing new. They have been around for over 100 years, and some of the earliest models is this one over here, the Expo. At that time, concealing a camera as a pocket watch was definitely an innovative idea, and most people wouldn't notice it. But in the spy world, nothing is as it seems.